I'm going to show you the absolute fastest way to animate Mr. Beast subtitles inside Premiere. We build it once, and we can use it forever. We're going to build a motion graphics template in After Effects that we can use for all of our captions. And then we'll convert Premiere Pro's static captions into our animated subtitles. This pop-up style animation is super easy inside After Effects. There's no expressions, no complicated code, just a couple keyframes, and we'll be done. So open up After Effects, and let's get into it. In After Effects, come to the text tool and type some text. I'm using the font Komika Axis, and I'll throw the link in the description, but this will work with any font. Select the text layer and hit S for scale, and then animate the scale to go from 0 to 100% over 4 frames. And we instantly have this animation. To make it bounce, change the last keyframe to 105%, and then go forward 2 frames, and set this one to 95. Go forward another 2 frames, and set this one to 100. Select them all and hit F9 to easy ease. Hit play, and now we have a bounce animation. Then click this icon for motion blur, and now we have sexy motion blur applied. Now how do we get this animation in Premiere Pro? We export a motion graphics template. Open window, essential graphics. And then toggle open the source text and drag it into the essential graphics panel. When we edit the text inside the panel, that updates our text on screen. This field on the left is the controls display name, so I'll call it source text. Anything we drag into this panel, we can edit inside Premiere. So I'll also drag the position property into the essential graphics panel. That way we can also reposition the text in Premiere. I'll reset our text and then name this template and hit the export button. We can save to the default local templates folder and then hop back inside Premiere. Open the graphics panel in Premiere, and we see the MOGRT we exported. We can drop it onto the timeline, and we can edit the text inside of it. And we can edit all the MOGRT settings, like the size and position. So to use this for captions, we can simply copy the captions from our text panel and paste it inside the MOGRT. Then I'll hold Option on Mac or Alt on PC, and click and drag to duplicate the clip, and slide it over to align with the next caption, and then copy and paste the next block of text. We can slide this out and do that for the rest of the sequence. Hit play.
Today, I'm going to show you how to make this trendy per word bounce animation inside After Effects, and then bring it to Premiere for animated subtitles. Let's get into it.
And now we have the text bounce animation inside Premiere. But instead of doing this manually, we can use the Captioneer plugin. I'll export my captions to an SRT file and drop it onto the Captioneer panel. Then I can select the MOGRT that we built, come down to Create, and hit Add MOGRTs. And that inserts all the MOGRTs onto the timeline with the exact same text and timing from our captions. And we still have complete control to edit each one independently.
All right, let's hop back to After Effects and check out something a little more advanced. This time we'll pop on each word, one at a time.
Go ahead and delete those scale keyframes, because instead we'll be using a text animator. Come to Text, Animate Scale, and this adds a text animator. We're going to change the text animator scale to 0, and then animate the range start to go from 0 to 100%. Now each letter scales up one at a time. Toggle open Advanced. It's currently scaling on each character one at a time, but we can change this to lines, or change this to words to automatically bounce on each word one at a time.
Now here's the most important setting.
Come up to More Options, and let's change Anchor Point Grouping to Word. Now each word pops in with the correct letter spacing.
Here's trick number two.
Right now, everything is scaling from the bottom of each word, but we can change this bounce point. As we drag this value from 0, it moves the red X, and that's where each word is going to scale and bounce from. So if we drag this up to minus 100, it scales from the top of each word. Or we can drag this down and scale from the center of each word. In general, to make this look right, we want the anchor point grouping and the advanced based on setting to be the same. So I can change these both to lines, and it will scale on each line one at a time. I'll set this back to words. And I'll expand this so we can see what's going on and have more room to work. To give it a bounce, we can just duplicate the text animator and slide it out so it's delayed by 2 frames. and then change the scale to 120%. Now when we play this back, you'll see that it scales up to 120 and then down to 100. For a more extreme bounce, we could change it to 150. Or for a lighter bounce, we could change it to 110. So you can play with this, but I like 120. We can duplicate the animator again. And this time, instead of going above 100%, we'll go below 100%. This one will be subtle, so let's do 95%. Delay it by another 2 frames. And now we have a second bounce. So it bounces up and overshoots, bounces down, and then settles.
And that's it. Per word bounce animation is that easy.
I'm going to add font and color controls so we can edit those in Premiere. First, I'll hit Edit Properties and turn on all these checkboxes. Now we can edit the font style. My text, fill, and stroke colors are black and white, so we can add a tint effect to the text, and that will let us remap those black and white colors to any colors. We can right-click and hit Add Property to Essential Graphics, and rename these both to fill and stroke color. And this will let us customize our fill and stroke colors once we're inside Premiere. And we can re-export this MOGRT and overwrite the previous version. And then back in Premiere, I'll use Captioneer to instantly add it to the timeline. I can change the colors on one MOGRT and move the position down. In Captioneer, come over to the Update tab and hit Copy. And that copies all the MOGRT settings, so the font, color, and position all got copied in the background. And then we can select all the rest of the MOGRTs and hit Paste, and they all instantly update. So let's check out what we made.
Today, I'm going to show you how to make this trendy per-word bounce animation inside After Effects, and then bring it to Premiere for animated subtitles. Let's get into it.
Awesome.
Now we have this per-word bounce animation inside Premiere, and it was super easy. And it's all live on the timeline, so we can keep editing this, add effects, change it however we like. The point is that I can build my own custom MOGRT in After Effects, and then seamlessly use it here for animated captions. And because MOGRTs use all the power of After Effects, that means you could even write custom expressions, use 3D text, or use plugins like Saber or Deep Glow in your MOGRTs. So this really allows you to create any design for your channel, brand, whatever, and use it inside Premiere. So this technique is super powerful for subtitles. Leave a comment if you want to see how to create more advanced designs. Thanks for watching, and catch you in the next one.